Welcome back to Block TV. This is Block Hits, where we round up the latest headlines in crypto. Zai Crypto reports how Bitcoin breaks below 11K as Trump's administration delays tariff on selected Chinese goods. CoinDesk reports how UK's Pension and Welfare Department eyes DLT for faster payments. Ethereum News reports how amending complaint against Ripple cites SEC guidelines. CoinDesk reports how SEC files emergency action against organizer of fraudulent $15 million ICO. And NewsBTC reports how Samsung quietly adds Bitcoin to its blockchain key store. Now, the Zai Crypto reports how the Trump administration has announced a delay on tariffs on Chinese goods where 75% or more of the 2018 U.S. imports of that product were from China. Now, Bitcoin took a hit as a result of being the cryptocurrency that worried investors so far have jumped into to hedge against a worsening trade war. And Bitcoin dropped below 11K on the news and on the delay. The delay is only expected to take hold until December 15th, when retailers will have had a chance to stock up their inventories for the holidays. CoinDesk reports how the UK's Pension and Welfare Division of Government, the Department for Work and Pensions, or DWP, says it is investigating blockchain technology as an efficient, modern, fast, scalable, flexible, innovative, and available 24/7 way of making sure the 20 million customers receive their payments on time. Now, that's not my words, that's Richard Laycock, a deputy director at the DWP. But Dick, I couldn't have described blockchain better myself. Ethereum News reports how a new amended complaint against Ripple focuses on the SEC's framework for digital assets to outline how the XRP might be a security. This would be the first federal case to do so. The plaintiffs claimed they believed that XRP is a security based on the fact that, quote, XRP purchases made an investment of money in a common enterprise, XRP investors had a reasonable expectation of profits, and the success of XRP requires effort of Ripple and others. Now, this lawsuit has been going on for a while now, but this is the first time that Ripple actually has to give a response to the lawsuit. CoinDesk reports how the SEC has obtained a temporary restraining order freezing the assets of Reggie Middleton, the organizer of the $14.8 million Veritasium ICO. Middleton is accused of conducting a fraudulent and illegal ICO in 2017 and for manipulating the value of the coin afterwards, including pumping the coin with false statements about the product, false and fake investors, fake trading volume, and fake returns, etc., etc. The freeze came after Middleton allegedly began transferring 10,000 Ethereum worth about $2.3 million of investors' funds to other coins and wallets and another 750 Ethereum to his personal account days after the SEC informed Middleton's lawyers that they would be pursuing legal action. Lastly, NewsBTC reports how Samsung, the world's number one smartphone seller, will add Bitcoin support to its blockchain key store. This will allow users to use Bitcoin with compatible apps on the phone's built-in hardware wallet, including the newest Galaxy phones. Up until now, only Ethereum-based coins worked with the phones. Now, this feature isn't available yet to the public, only for developers to work on. Either way, this will put a Bitcoin hardware wallet and interface into the hands of hundreds of millions of people around the world. This is Blockheads. Make sure to check out and stay tuned at blocktv.com.
For more news and updates, follow us on Twitter